to die. Of course I'm, yeah, very afraid. There are times where, well, that's a hard question. God. Yeah, obviously there are times where I'm frightened to die. And the reason for it, because there's so often, life is so good. And to not be a part of that is not a good thing. So there are times where I understand and I'm comfortable with dying, but most of the time I choose to live.
Even though there's so many bad things in the world that happen all around us every single day, like accidents and earthquakes and natural disasters and things like that, I still think there is a God, because there's so many good things that we don't notice or that we don't even give credit for. Like, even the sole fact that we get up in the morning and that we can feel things. We can feel happy, we can feel sad. The feelings of happiness, it's like, it's as if we don't feel them because we try to focus on the bad things. But isn't the feeling of happiness, isn't that the best thing in the world?
Everyone, you have to have a soul. You have to have a soul because of how people are. I mean, you could raise two people, give them equally everything, right? And basically, because of the foundations of how they grow up, you would expect them to turn out the same, but one of them will turn out different than the other. One of them will be really nice and want to do charity work, and the other one will want to, you know, kill people or, you know, be a lawyer or something evil like that.
Assumes that there's some sort of a soul that carries on afterwards. How else would our minds or our memories continue to function when the physical matter is broken down? I would like to think that there's a soul. I don't know that I believe in internal damnation or the pearly gates, but I would like to think that a part of us lives on. Some would say that we live on only in the memories of others. Obviously, we don't know.
It would feel like falling.
Lasting most of my life, I'll probably be thinking about what's gonna happen next. Like, what's the next step after this? Like, what's gonna happen to me? And then I'll probably be a little bit scared, because I'll know, like, this is it. It could be nothing after this, it could be something. That's it.
Does my mind die with me? I don't think so. I think the mind is not something solid. The mind is the thought, and I think the thought goes on. The body becomes dust.
Thank you. what's real to me? I honestly don't know what's real. Like, I believe everything's a dream. We all live dreams. This right now is a dream. So reality, I don't believe in it. Reality is now.
Is there such thing as present time? I think it's... Let me think how to phrase that. The present escapes from us as we live it, right? And I think that the present is so fleeting that we are always living in either the past or the future.
This place, Earth, I'm sure there's something better. If not, well then, we're all screwed.
I'm afraid of not existing, because that would suck. You wouldn't be able to think or see, but also, you wouldn't know that you didn't exist. So, it's hard to really answer that question. I would be afraid if I couldn't think, but I couldn't think about it, so it wouldn't matter. So the question's kind of a double negative.
I think that, once we die, that's it. Like, it's just nothingness. It's kind of scary, but it's, you have to accept it.
What do I think I'll be thinking the last few moments of my life? Goethe said more light when he was dying. Thomas Alva Edison said, "There's something beautiful over there." Napoleon said, "Head of the army." Frank Sinatra said, "I'm losing." I would like to think that when I die, I would have the strength to say, "Excelsior." Excelsior means onward and upward.